Okay, is everybody having a good time? Okay. So, you know, I like to believe that I am a really funny guy, right? I like to believe that I have great punchlines, that I have great comic timing, and that I know exactly what it takes to crack the perfect joke. Unfortunately, nobody agrees with me. So, after years of trying in drawing rooms to make people laugh, I've realized that comedy is really hard. But our next guest is somebody who makes comedy look very easy. He has been performing all over the world. He has put together this great collective of comedians called East India Comedy, who've been, you know, killing it everywhere, right? But today, let's make it a little hard for him. Let us promise that whatever he says over the next 30 minutes, we are not going to laugh. And then, let's get ready to break that promise, because here comes Sorabh Pant. Thank you so much, guys. How are you feeling? That's awesome. I haven't been whistled this much as since I went to Khan Market yesterday. I love how all the young people know who I am, all the old people are like, kone ye takla? Thank you so much to Kapil Sharma's band leader. But anyway, thank you so much for coming out here today. I really appreciate it. My name is Sorabh Pant. How many people know, anyone knows who I am here? How many people know who I am? Thank you so much. Wow, really, this is getting sleazy now, guys. I feel like I should show some parts of my body for this whistling. Thank you once again. But for those of you who don't know me, my name is Sorabh Pant. I'm a stand-up comedian. It's a very hard job to explain to people what I do. My mom can't understand what I do. Like, every time I'm at a party, my mom is like, that's my son, he's a standby comedian. I'm not a standby comedian. But aside from this, I'm also an author. I've written a novel called Underdelhi, which is a bestseller. In that, I'm trying my best to sell it. But most importantly, I'm very proud to be the founder of East India Comedy, which is the number three comedy collective in the country. We're number three out of five people. Number one is Office of Rahul Gandhi. Number two is News R. AIB is fourth. Anyway, nobody believes that. But yeah, this is fun, man. I'm very happy. By the way, we got a lot of people. Who are all the people wearing the brown school uniform? Which school is this? Vasant Valley. I've been to Vasant numerous times. Where is the valley? I've not seen a single valley in Vasant.
SRM.
SRM? You guys are from Chennai. I love Chennai, man. I love Chennai. You drive down Chennai, and everywhere you go, you take a left, there's a face looking at you. You take a right, the face is looking at you. You take a left, the face is looking at you. Like, I'm pretty sure Jayalalitha thinks that Tamil Nadu is a Facebook wall. Like, it's just. We got people from Miranda House also. Yeah, right there. I love Miranda House. It's a college named after a soft drink. That's awesome. Right next to 7-Up House. It's damn nice. What about people from SRCC? Anyone from SRCC? Yeah, I love SRCC. One of your alumni includes Vijay Goyal. Our sports minister, who is really obsessed with taking a selfie, guys, you should be proud of yourselves. But anyway, let's do this, guys. Very happy to be here. Let's do this.
So, were you always like this?
or did you become like this along the way?
A lot of substance abuse. I snort dhoklas. I mean, there's a particular reason why I look like Nana Patekar ate Vinod Kambli. No, I mean, I was born in Delhi, actually, and raised in Mumbai, yeah, which means I'm hated in two states. And I was in a college called Sydenham College in Mumbai, which is a wonderful college where it's very famous for the fact that Hrithik Roshan went to that college. It's a college where you go there primarily if you don't want to attend lectures. And I graduated from there, and I really needed some attention, and that's where I became like this. My sister is very good looking and very intelligent and very smart, so I needed to take the attention away from her.
She obviously went to a different college.
She went through a different college. She was smart, and she got scholarships to go to Switzerland. I got scholarships to go to Nala Sopara. I'm always been a little insane. So yeah.
So how does the joke journey begin? I mean, is there like, did you follow the normal path, Santa Banta? Well, I mean, what do these words mean to you? Is this the beginning of your sort of journey into comedy?
Santa Banta wasn't part of my journey because I'm not a racist. But I mean, when you say Santa Banta, I think of wallpapers. To be no dirty people here. Okay. SRM University knows exactly what I'm saying when I say Santa Banta wallpapers. They are totally into it. The journey began because I was in school and I graduated from a boys' school. And that makes you a very filthy human being. How many guys went to a boys' school here? Yeah, anyone?
Come on, you're out there.
All you guys, yeah. It affects you in weird ways. Like no woman wants to talk to a guy who's like, hi. Nobody wants that. So to get attention from women primarily, I decided that I would just scream and shout and hopefully somebody will look at me. And nobody did except my mom. So that's where it started. It effectively started to get attention and have people look away from the achievements of my sister. I don't want to make a Rahul Gandhi joke, but like I'm the Rahul Gandhi of comedy. Everyone prefers my sister, but I'm in the limelight.
And then somewhere very quickly along the way, Twitter seems to have happened to you.
Yeah.
You're like this powerful force on Twitter who everybody is abusing constantly, 500 times a day.
Yeah.
How do you deal with that?
But we must acknowledge the fact that if anyone's on Twitter, my Twitter handle is @hankypanty. please tell your parents to censor me out. And the thing is that there's generally a crazy amount of trolling. Like I had one guy troll me in the middle. I made some silly joke, which I do usually. And he's like, you takla, why didn't you die? You suck, you takla, sala takla, and whatever. So I told him, I'm like, hey, if you don't like my jokes, just unfollow. He tweeted back to me saying, why bro? You don't like constructive feedback. How is saying go die constructive feedback? Twitter is a great forum. I'm obsessed with Twitter. I get into Twitter fights with everyone on a regular basis. It's so futile, right? Like nobody on Twitter has ever said you are right. I apologize. Like that's never happened. It's always like you are wrong and I'm the genius. And I think what's happening in a very weird way is that trolling on Twitter has actually come to fore with regards to what we behave as like. As human beings, like even in general, we don't want to listen to any voice that sort of disagrees with us in any shape or form. And I think that needs to stop because, guys, that's not constructive feedback. I like these guys who are holding up these really weird-looking sticks. makes me feel really. I feel like I'm at a Coldplay concert right now. But I gotta acknowledge the fact that they are like very important people today. Like I'm the main reason I'm here is to see Ovesi versus Subramanian Swami. That's the main reason I'm here. That's like The Rock versus Stone Cold Steve Austin. I love it. And so many esteemed people on the panel. You got like all these well-qualified and people who've made achievements. Me being here, I feel like Falguni Pathak opening for Coldplay. This is just it's damn weird.
But Sorabh, you've also become deeply political over the last 2-3 years. You know, right. A lot of the comedy that you do is about politics. Right. But don't you find that hard? I mean, politics is comedy enough these days.
Well, I mean, like for example, what's happening with Samajwadi Party is just hilarious. It's like Big Boss House in politics, where everyone's like, "Mulayam chahte hain, aap ghar se nikal jaiye." Like, but Papa, I live here, Papa. And politics is hilarious. My favorite thing that I heard yesterday was about I don't want to do the same joke again, but let's call him RG. And apparently he was about to board a flight and his SPG guys, they wanted to check the licenses of the Indigo pilots. And they also wanted to check if the fuel in the plane was unadulterated or no. I'm like, when did your guys become like PUC guys? Like, what is... Like, they're going to check it and they're like, acha taste karta hai, unadulterated nahi hai. What is... So, yeah, I mean, politics in India is generally very fascinating and hilarious. And I love the terms we throw around at each other, right? Like... Yeah, like everyone's like, if you don't agree with somebody, like you're Sanghi, you're Aptad, you're Congressi, you're Prestidute, you're Custard, you're Vada Pav, you're like anything, you're Savita Bhabi, anything people are saying, it's just illogical. So I like talking about politics, and I think it's great that young people here, especially like Vasant Valley, knows everything about politics, guys. They understand. I was seeing, it's good that young people are taking an interest in politics, but I don't think we should repeat the thing of constantly labeling each other. Like, we're constantly looking at, this guy doesn't agree with my worldview, so I will just rip on him and give him a label. I think we need to stop basically labeling each other. The only time labels are important is when Zara has a sale. That's the... or Lux, Cozy and Banyan, which is where I shop. But otherwise, I think we should listen to like other people who disagree with us and stop labeling people constantly, I mean, with regards to politics. And by the way, guys, please give it up for Yogendra Yadav. It is such a pleasure for...
How do you make jokes, but when stuff like this happens, that it turns out that Kejriwal's tongue is too big for his mouth. It turns out that in Bihar, Nitish Kumar says, if you are drinking, I'm going to lock up your whole family.
Yeah.
I mean, how do you make a joke after this? Isn't this already the joke?
Listen, so again, I think people should drink responsibly. I don't, but other people should. And I have no problem with certain kinds of prohibition, like Gujarat, where you can legally drink in Gujarat. And if you're a tourist, you can drink in Gujarat and stuff like that. But yeah, the Bihar laws are crazy, where it's basically like, you are drinking, I'm going to arrest your whole family. Like, it makes no sense. It's like, you can't apply it to other crimes. You can't say, "Ha, Fufa ji, maine murder kar liya, jail chalte hai." Like, that doesn't make sense. How is this logically making any sense? And the thing is, people are voting for this. Like, in India, the thing is that we genuinely believe that if somebody makes a moral statement on you, that person is suddenly superior to you. Which I've never understood. Where we constantly, like, look at people and you're like, "Hey, you shouldn't be drinking. You drink, that means you're a bad person." That doesn't make sense. I mean... Okay, Vijay Mallya is an exemption. And politics itself is generally hilarious. But I personally have not noticed the fact that we keep talking about censorship of comedians and stuff like that. I haven't faced it as such. What invariably happens is that online, you'll put up a video saying something about, say, Narendra Modi, and then Modi fans are like, "How dare you say something about Modi? You are a aptard." And then you say something about Kejriwal, and they're like, "How dare you say something about Kejriwal? You're a fan of Modi." Then you say something about Congress, and people are like, "How dare you say something about Congress? You must be from... Nala Sopara, sure." I personally haven't faced any censorship as yet, and also, like, I'm speaking on behalf of other comedians. Whenever you censor us and create this whole furor about Sachin Tendulkar and Snapchat, you just made that comedian far more famous than he was before that video. So thank you so much for being RPR, basically. I haven't faced it personally too much myself. So, yeah.
So tell me then, when you go out on stage, are you thinking that you're going to offend people? Are you think you're going to entertain them? Do you think you're going to inform them? I mean, you're playing various roles. How do you differentiate between them, and what is your concern?
I just want to make people laugh. I mean, like, that's the whole idea. The idea is just to be this juvenile, disgusting human being who people sort of listen to on a regular basis. And my intention of coming for a comedy show is, like, maybe there'll be a message, like, for 30 seconds in the entire show, but the main intention is to make people laugh. And fortunately, I don't know if anyone here has seen EIC Outrage. Is anyone familiar with EIC Outrage?
Yes, of course.
EIC Outrage is something that we do online, which is basically a news comedy show where we take the current news and we basically make fun of it. So it's exactly like what normal news channels like you guys do. But more people watch us, so... they don't. I mean, but the idea is there. The idea is we also come a lot on news debates and stuff like that. We talk a lot on topics which we don't understand.
Why is it that Bollywood gets special attention from you?
Bollywood is like, oh my God, Bollywood. Guys, there was a movie, Raaz Reboot has been approved by someone. Somebody saw Raaz. And they're like, Imran Hashmi taking his tongue and going, I mean... And by the way, that is a horror movie. Like, I wake up every night like, Imran Hashmi is kissing me. What a nightmare. Please don't. Bollywood is a favorite target because, like right now, for example, the very reputed actress who's been known for very seminal roles, Katrina Kaif, she is being given the Smita Patil Memorial Award. Which is amazing. Like, and the way most of these things work is that Katrina Kaif was free on the day, and they're like, "Aari hai to de do." Like, that's our attitude towards giving awards to people. I'm not going to hate on Bollywood, but some of the stuff they do is really stupid. Like, but also the opposite side of it. Like, anyone saw Bar Bar Dekho? This is the country, by the way. Nobody's seen it. Bar Bar Dekho got into trouble with the censors because there was a point in the movie where they talk about ladies, the... lingerie. Let's say lingerie. And they censored out the word because they're like, this is too much. And I'm like, but people wear that. It's like, if he had said langote, it's fine. Like, that makes no sense. So there's a lot of censorship and there's a lot of needless censorship, and also I think that people should be allowed to say whatever they want. And also, I mean, to be honest, I don't understand why we censor Bollywood. We've discovered over the last like 3 years that even if you give Bollywood a free rein, it's not like they're going to get better. Like, I mean, Sultan, everyone's spoken about this numerous times. Sultan, where Salman Khan, the prototype of greatness, He wins a gold medal after training for 4 months. 4 months of training! The only way he can do that is if he ran over his entire opposition. This makes no sense. And in the movie, Anushka Sharma is like this amazing wrestler and she quits because she's like, "Main to ghar mein baithungi." Bachcha paida karna hai. Aap jeet lijiye na, please. So, I think Bollywood needs to do some self-censorship and look inside. Again, there have been some great movies. There was, I saw Kapoor & Sons, which is a wonderful movie. Kapoor & Sons was great. Wazir was awesome. There's some fantastic movies. And anything with Kangana Ranaut is great, man. I love Kangana Ranaut. She's amazing.
She's going to be here this evening.
Yeah, she's awesome. I love Kangana. Everything she does is amazing. So yeah.
She's going to be here this evening.
She's going to be here. I'm going to be stalking at the back like madam. One selfie, please.
Okay, last question. So when you go to watch a movie,
yeah,
are you going to watch a movie or are you saying, oh, material? When you go for a party, are you like saying, okay, I'm going to like scope these guys out and make fun of them later? Or are you like just enjoying yourself, going watching a movie? How do you get your material? Is this
hunt? I have a baby right now, so I haven't been able to. The only movie I'm seeing these days is SpongeBob SquarePants. And Dora the Explorer, which is just... Dora the Explorer is a very weird show, man. It's It's very strange. There's a show there by Dora the Explorer. For those of you who don't know what the show is, it's basically this little girl with this haircut where she looks classy. And oh, hi. Good evening. Hi. Do I have to leave? Am I that disgusting? Sorry? Oh, I'm getting a gift. I'm being kicked out because I'm inappropriate and not important. But yeah, I think since whatever, I mean, I look at everything from a point of view of a sense of humor. I have zero political affiliations. I don't care about any political party. I hate every person equally if they do something stupid. If they do something good, great. And I think that's just on a end note. What I want to say is that I think we become way too cynical in general, and we do make fun of everyone, including me. But we need to start appreciating when people do good stuff as well. Everything is not horrible in this country. Things are great. The fact that we have intelligent people and we're being able to do something like this is great. And I love this country. And I think we should make fun of people who are stupid, but also compliment things which are good, which is a lot in this country. So that's all I want to say.
So that was 30 seconds of lesson.
30 seconds, guys.
Of lesson.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sorabh Pant.
Thank you so much.
I invite on stage India Today Group CEO Mr. Ashish Bagga to kindly come and give you a nice gift, Sorabh. For
oh, I got a gift. That's Yay. Awesome. Is it money?
Wow, we don't know.
Oh, wow, this is a nice. Oh, now I have check-in back. Thank you, sir. That's so nice of you. this is far more precious than money. These are the kind of labels we should care about, guys. Thank you.